This is episode 248, and today we're chatting about reduced inflammation, overall wellness, functional medicine, as in food as medicine, staying away from medicine options, biohacking, and so much more. I'm sitting in my rental car waiting for our dog Coconut to get out of her puppy play date. It's been so important for her to be around dogs as we transition to being a 3-being family as opposed to a 5-being family. And I figured while she's out playing with her puppy friends, I would sit in the car and record an episode with you. So, hey, if you can hear the AC running in the background, it is very hot down here in Florida this week. Our guest today is Brian D'Alessandro. He is the Eat & Hemp CEO who has spent his career developing brands and integrating marketing campaigns for multinational accounts. In 2010, he founded The Humans, a brand development agency servicing values-driven clients through a variety of brand development, strategic, and creative marketing services. Plus, Brian knows a lot about hemp, like so much about hemp and CBD. Holy moly. I thought I knew some stuff about CBD, but he takes it to a whole other level. If you've heard all this craze about CBD and you're like, I want to get in on this action, please listen to today's episode to really, really immerse yourself in how CBD works, how to choose the right CBD for you. And if you want to go even deeper down into all of this, I wrote a pretty epic blog post that took us weeks to put together because it was so much research required. You can find it by checking out today's show notes by going to ketodietpodcast.com. Just look for episode 248 on that page, and there you're going to find all the CBD resources and studies that Brian mentions throughout the episode, plus the blog post that I put together on how to choose the right CBD oil and exactly what to look for when you're holding a CBD oil in your hand. What to look for. So again, if you go to ketodietpodcast.com and then just scroll down on that page until you find episode 248, and all those links will be there. Now, if you decide to cut out all the research because you just don't have the time to research CBD brands and go to the health food store and go to various online websites and do the research that you need to do in order to find a safe CBD product, and you decide to go with Eat & Hemp, you can use the code KETODIET at eatandhempcbd.com/ketodiet for 20% off your entire order. That includes all CBD products from Eat & Hemp. Now, in addition to Eat & Hemp, I have not personally, but my dog Lexi used to take CV Sciences. Now, I find compared to the potency of Eat & Hemp, CV Sciences does work, but you need a whole bunch more to have the same effect. So Lexi used to take 15 milligrams of CV Sciences CBD in a little capsule form because their other CBD has stevia and other stuff in it, so she had to go with the capsule form. Now, when we switched over to eating hemp for her, it went down to 6 milligrams. So just so you have an idea, like, the potency is just so much more, and that's one of the many things we're going to be talking about in today's episode. If you have questions about today's content, you can go to healthfulpursuit.com/contact and ask me. I will feature your question in an upcoming episode. Kevin marks them all down in our inbox, and that's how we put together our Q&A episodes. If you have a question for me, you want me to answer it on the show, go to healthfulpursuit.com/contact and I will get to it. Also, you can catch up on previous podcast episodes and notes from today's show by going to ketodietpodcast.com and just search on that page for episode 248, as all the podcast episodes that have ever existed for the Keto Diet Podcast are on that page. Okay, let's do this thing. Hey, I'm Leanne Vogel. You're listening to the Keto Diet Podcast. I've created a free guide with tips on how to start keto and maintain your fat-fueled life. Grab it at healthfulpursuit.com/free as a little thank you for listening to the show.
I co-founded Eat & Hemp about 4 years ago with my partners Mark Just and Dan Dolgen. So Dan and Mark own a 2,500-plus acre organic farm in upstate New York in the town of Eaton, hence the name Eaton Hemp. For any of you who are familiar with New York, it's in Hamilton or near Colgate University. It's a really special farm because it was the first farm licensed to grow hemp in New York State. Mark took originally three defunct dairy farms. And if you guys have driven around New York at all, you'll see it's rampant with derelict farms, farms that have pretty much been abandoned. And a lot of this is due to big agriculture or mono farming, and they just haven't been able to make ends meet. And so when Mark originally bought the farm, he purchased three defunct dairy farms that were a total mess. They were manure lagoons, and it was in really bad shape. So he devoted himself for 7 years to rehabilitating the whole property, and then went through the long process of converting the farm for organic certification. About that time, Dan met up with Mark, and they ended up becoming equal partners in the farm. Dan is not what you would think of for your typical farmer. He comes from a government background. He worked in counterterrorism. And it's one of those things, as in life, you know, a lot of the things that lead us to where we are, they don't seem like they have any relevance until you get there. And so for Dan, his government background was instrumental in making him able to navigate the political landscape and helping to rewrite policy around legalizing hemp. It's for that reason that they got the first license to grow hemp in New York State. It was pretty crazy when they did. You know, they had armed DEA agents that were there as they planted the seeds. Just so ridiculous. So I had a perfect case of a crop such as industrial hemp. So that means it has no CBD or THC in it, being classified as a Schedule 1 narcotic alongside heroin. So pretty wild how far this has come, and we'll get more into that. But Dan sits on the governor's hemp and CBD advisory board. So suffice it to say, we're not a company that's just jumping on the bandwagon here. You know, there is this whole idea of the green rush of people chasing the cannabis field. We believe deeply in the hemp plant and work hard for policy reform, and continue to do so, and work hard at educating customers so that they can get the full benefits of the plant, because we've seen that with ourselves and with our friends, family, and loved ones. Now, after legally being allowed to grow hemp, it was time to decide what to do with the hemp. Being that hemp is the most versatile crop out there, we have a lot of options to choose from. I'm sure many of you know hemp could be used for everything from fuel to plastics to textiles for construction. But we were immediately impressed with how tasty the seeds were, and more importantly, how nutritious they were. We had partnerships with Cornell and with SUNY Morrisville, and so we had ongoing work being done that just kept on giving us more reinforcement about just how incredible the plant was. But to break it down a little bit, a serving size of hemp seeds includes 8 grams of proteins, plant-based protein, a complete protein source, which is hard to find in plant-based proteins. It has all 9 essential amino acids, perfect balance of omega-3 and 6, and it has 27 total aminos, so a complete profile. It also has over 10 grams of fiber, with only 1 net carb. So keto fans, it's pretty stellar as far as having a snack. And, you know, this is one of the main reasons that I got so excited about this project, was creating snacks and products that allowed us to stay healthy while living busy lifestyles. The fiber is made up of both soluble and insoluble fiber, which includes a resistant starch, and that's a natural prebiotic. So it promotes gut health naturally, really, you know, just unparalleled when you look at its nutritional qualities. So that led to us starting with snacks. You know, we also entered there because we knew that there's a lot of confusion around hemp and CBD and marijuana, and a lot of it gets cloudy, and there's just a lot of baggage that comes along with it. And so we knew educating was going to be an important part of it, and we thought that food would be a good place to start, where it was in people's adjacent possible. And, you know, we also all live on-the-go lifestyles, and that also at times keep us seated for a good part of the day. And we wanted to create snacks that tasted great, that were very filling, and most importantly, were really healthy. Now, the deeper we got into learning about hemp, the more amazed we were by CBD. We studied it and met with all the players in the field. But since we're really big on organic farming practices, we waited until we could produce USDA organic certified products before going to market. Fortunately, that came late last year, and we're proud to be one of the only USDA organic certified CBD brands on the market. I'm really excited to share what makes our product so unique and so high in quality. You know, let's remember that science tells us that at least 90% of illness and disease is stress related. Inflammation becomes a natural response to stress. So, you know, these two work together and compound, and they wreak havoc. Now, one of our partners at Eaton Hemp is a leading functional medicine practitioner. You might have heard of him, Dr. Will Cole. His work focuses on just this. He was the author of Ketotarian, and also his most recent book is The Inflammation Spectrum, which explains how inflammation is at the core of most common health issues, including weight gain, fatigue, hormone balance, and even autoimmune conditions. Now, stress and inflammation can be beneficial. They have a purpose, although when they become chronic, they can lead to constant tissue breakdown and a compromised immune system, both things that add to, you know, these illnesses that we see reoccurring all over the place. But by getting in touch with our bodies, we're able to recognize the symptoms of stress and inflammation in order to prevent them from happening. One of the ways I like to look at this, and maybe this is me, but it's through a teaching from Cesar Millan, the dog whisperer. I like to take things from all areas. But, you know, his work takes what he calls these red zone cases, these high risk cases of dogs that get into the danger zone. And he defines that by them getting into a place where they'll attack another dog or a person by biting. And I think this applies, it transfers over to the same in our bodies and when our bodies start to attack itself, right? That is the idea of autoimmune disease and a lot of other illnesses that, you know, work the same way. The idea is that if you think of stress and the nervous system as a gauge on a car, once it gets into the red zone, it's already too late to address it. The best thing you could do is deal with the symptoms and try to soothe it to a place where then you could deal with the underlying conditions, right? Because once it's already at breaking point, it's too late. We want to catch it as it starts to build, and the sooner the better. With stress, this may mean noticing, you know, for me, when I'm starting to get tense and hiking up my shoulders or clenching my teeth, rather than when I'm all the way at the point of having an intense headache or lashing out at the coffee barista for spelling my name with an I. I mean, all of this is about getting more in touch with our body's natural systems so they can perform at their best. And that's all aiding in helping us to live longer and feel better. I'll get into how CBD is a great tool for this kit in just a bit. But first, I want to touch on the second point of the topic of homeostasis and how we could biohack it, CBD being a great tool for that. It's no secret that we're busier and more stressed than ever before. Now, we know that stress and inflammation are the cause of over 90% of illness, right? And while we're so overworked and over-caffeinated, this leads to our nervous systems being in a heightened state where we're constantly in fight or flight, or fight, flight, or freeze. And when you're in this fight or flight state, your body is producing all these great chemicals like cortisol and adrenaline, which pumps you full of, you know, life-saving chemicals. The issue is that they're life-saving if you're being chased by a tiger, or if you have a car coming at you and you need to jump out of the way. Not if you're afraid of being late for a meeting or getting enough likes on IG. I mean, you know, our lives have evolved a lot. The circumstances have evolved. Our body chemistry hasn't necessarily caught up with it. So some of these old systems that serve a function are now working in overdrive. When the body's autonomic nervous system is switched into what's called the sympathetic state, it uses all of its resources to survive rather than thrive. This is something, you know, in yoga, we practice a lot. We work with understanding and being in tune with when that sympathetic nervous system state kicks in, that fight or flight, and when we're switching over to our parasympathetic nervous system. And there are great tools to manage that, things like meditation and breathing techniques, even what we're eating, and of course, the surroundings we're in. But there's a lot of other great tools too. And, you know, I think what we eat and supplements such as CBD. But, you know, what happens here is, you know, when we get into that fight or flight state, a flash flood of hormones increases the body's alertness, and our heart rate. It sends extra blood to the muscles, which is all great in these situations. Our breathing starts to get quicker, and it delivers fresh oxygen to the brain and to the muscles, and we get a hit of glucose pumping into the bloodstream for that quick burst of energy. And according to the Harvard Medical School, this response happens so fast that people often don't even realize it's happened until it's done. Now, while this is an incredible survival mechanism, this system has no ability to de-stress the body after it occurs, right? So you have these two side-by-side part of the autonomic nervous system. You have that sympathetic and the parasympathetic. The body has this function to handle it. The parasympathetic nervous system takes over and it calms us back down. Now, the two of these systems work together and maintain a baseline of normal body function. This is what is known as homeostasis. You might remember this from our sixth grade biology class. But when we're disproportionately in this high stress state, our body doesn't have the ability to detox, and it leads to many illnesses. These include cardiovascular diseases like heart disease, even heart failure and hypertension. It includes high blood pressure. I mean, it just goes on and on. And beyond cardiovascular issues, it has been associated with kidney disease, type 2 diabetes, obesity, even Parkinson's. So as if that's not enough, it also has underlying issues, the sympathetic nervous system, with mental health conditions. These include anxiety, depression, chronic stress, and trouble with sleeping, which, you know, we know is a huge issue nowadays, especially with our screens, and severely decreased baseline energy overall. So the same way that the body can be tricked into staying into the survival state that wreaks havoc on our organs and our health, there are things we can do to bring our body back into its natural balance, back to homeostasis. This means our body is free to work at the optimal level for cognitive function, digestion, natural sleep rhythms. It reduces inflammation, and most importantly, that overall feeling of well-being, right? Because it's like going back to Maslow's hierarchy of needs. If you're in the survival state, you can't thrive. You can't go to these higher realms of living, of self-awareness, of self-actualization.
Homemade or store-bought, I love cookies. Always have and always will. And my husband, Kevin, loves them even more. My aunt calls him the cookie monster for good reason. He's a lean, mean cookie-eating machine, and he'll eat up any cookie, regardless of the ingredients. We keep all sorts of keto cookies in the house, for real, like four different brands at all times. But Kevin always devours the super fat cookies the very first, always. Doesn't matter what other brands, if there is a bag of super fat cookies in the house, whether it be chocolate chip or snickerdoodle, he will find it and he will eat it. Instead of inflammatory fats and loads of sugar, you can find ingredients like almond flour, coconut flour, grass-fed butter, grass-fed collagen in superfat cookies. They come in three different flavors: chocolate chip, snickerdoodle, and peanut butter chocolate chip. There's a flavor for every cookie connoisseur. I'm allergic to dairy, so I haven't been able to try them. I know it's a total bummer. So I trust my cookie monster husband's endorsement. I'll stick to superfat nut butter packets instead, but he's got his cookie game sorted. Load up on cookies or fat packs by heading to superfat.com and using the coupon code LEANNE, all in caps, at checkout for 15% off your whole order. Again, that's superfat.com with the coupon code LEANNE, LEANNE, at checkout for 15% off your order. Enjoy!
So along with the nervous system, there's another vital system that's just recently been rediscovered. This system is not new. Even the ancient Chinese knew about this over 3,000 years ago. It's as old as we are, and it's evolved with our surroundings. This system is called the endocannabinoid system, or ECS for short. I'll probably use that so I don't have to keep on using lingo. And I'm sorry, I'm trying to stay away from it, but some of it is important. It's comprised of cannabinoid receptors. And it's a crucial molecular system that the body uses to help maintain homeostasis. So the ECS produces two main endocannabinoid receptors, CB1 and CB2. CB1 receptors, and you'll hear about this in the CBD space sometimes, CB1 receptors are mostly found in the central nervous system, and CB2 receptors are mostly found in your peripheral nervous system, especially your immune cells. So again, this is how CBD really helps to work on the nervous system and the immune system. While ancient cultures like the Chinese have known about this system for a long time, we only rediscovered this back in the 90s. And the studies have been limited probably because it was discovered while researching THC, which historically received very limited research dollars. That's all, of course, changing as THC and cannabis has been legalized in many places and continues to be so. The ECS is complex, and experts don't yet fully understand exactly how it works or all of its potential functions. Now, there's a site, Research Trusted, and the source has linked ECS to a lot of processes. I'm just going to read down the list because it's very long. It includes appetite and digestion, metabolism, chronic pain, inflammation and other immune system responses, mood, learning and memory, motor control, sleep, cardiovascular system function, muscular formation, bone remodeling and growth, liver function, reproductive system function, stress, skin, and nerve function. So how about any of you guys out there? Does any of those tick your boxes? I mean, it's pretty incredible how much the endocannabinoid system actually manages. And, as you start to see how much CBD plays in stimulating the endocannabinoid system, it's really remarkable. All of these functions contribute to homeostasis, which is the stability of our internal environment. For example, if an outside force, such as pain from an injury or a fever, throws off your body's homeostasis, your ECS kicks in to help your body return to its ideal operation. Now, this is where CBD comes into play. CBD acts upon CB1 and CB2 receptors located throughout the body to produce a variety of potentially positive outcomes. By stimulating the endocannabinoid system, CBD promotes homeostasis. It reduces pain sensation and decreases inflammation. CBD is a natural anti-inflammatory. Our bodies are built to process this. And we're not the only ones. This is so cool. We share the ECS with almost every organism on the planet. Even earthworms have an endocannabinoid system. So this is as natural as medicine gets. And the way that I think about this is, while we can't quite understand the depth and wisdom of our systems that have evolved over millions of years, the notion that we have evolved alongside a plant like hemp that has naturally occurring CBD that naturally works with our endocannabinoid system, it means that we are meant to live together and they help us in this symbiotic way. And so it's really cool when we start to tap into how this dynamic works and how interconnected we all are. But back to the matter at hand, let's get into some of the background of the cannabis state as a whole, because I know there's a lot of confusion out there and there's just so much going on. First, I'm just going to start by breaking down the difference between marijuana, CBD, and hemp, right? They're all in the cannabis family and they each have different strains that work differently. We know that marijuana is a strain that has high occurring amounts of THC and CBD. Those are the two compounds that work in marijuana. Then you have CBD, which is a strain of the hemp plant, which is going to grow and have naturally occurring amounts of CBD, of cannabidiol. It is going to have low trace amounts of THC, far below anything that's going to ever get you high. And then you have hemp, which is an industrial version of the cannabis plant that grows big and just like other grains. And this is more about the nutritional quality of this. You plant, tons of seeds and you then harvest with big combines and then you can take the seeds and make products into them. So now that I've looked at a few of the different variations, the varieties of cannabis, let's talk about the legality of it. So the Hemp Farming Act is the law that removed hemp, which defined as cannabis with less than 0.3% THC, it removed it from the Schedule I Controlled Substances list. Again, I mentioned this earlier. This is that list with cocaine, with heroin, with LSD, you know, very different class of medicines. So this removed it from it and made an ordinary agricultural commodity, something that could be bought, sold, traded, and grown across the country. Now, when it comes to CBD, this is that strain that's got a high occurrence of cannabinoids, very low amounts of THC, the psychoactive part of marijuana. So CBD will not get you high. CBD is legal when sold as a topical, such as lotions and salves, and it's legal to sell as a supplement, such as in tincture form. But where you get into trouble in many states at this time in 2020 in the US is when it's sold as food. So gummies, chocolates, or adding it to any other food, because it's sold legally as a supplement, not as a food product. This will change over time, but this is where we're at right now. Now, on our journey, we have faced some wild hurdles through not being allowed to advertise and market our products at all, even the hemp food products, which have no CBD or THC. So there are policies in place on a lot of the large marketing platforms, like the social media platforms, that put it into a big blanket sentiment against ingestible hemp. So there's a lot of confusion there still, but you know, we're working on the policy side. We're actively working with Facebook on policy reform to bring it to its rightful place. We've also been restricted about being able to make claims about the product's effectiveness. So you'll see when we promote our products, or even on our website, we're not talking a lot about the specific claims and health benefits because we're not allowed to, not because they don't exist. So that's why, again, it's important that people get informed, take their health back into their own control, and get educated about how these different plants and medicines work for us.
You know, what I love more than anything in the entire world is helping people. And when I meet a complete stranger and they're telling me about symptoms that they're having or symptoms that their dog is having or their loved one, oftentimes the first thing that comes into my head is, you should try CBD oil. And I'm in fact sitting in my car right now. I just drove an hour and a half to a friend's place to drop off a bottle of Eat & Hemp CBD oil. Their dog's having a really difficult time with an inflammatory condition. Nobody knows what it is. And I just thought, again, you need to try CBD oil. Now, CBD oil has massively reduced my symptoms of anxiety, but CBD oil does so much more, including inflammation reduction, improving digestive function, improving sleep quality, reduces acne. But here's what you have to know before you grab a random bottle and start supplementing. Research your options thoroughly. Look for a CBD oil that uses hemp seed oil as the carrier oil. Now, the hemp seed oil means that the plant has been kept in its purest whole plant form, allowing for the terpenes and cannabinoids to work together in unison in your body to give you the powerful entourage effect that everyone is always raving about when it comes to CBD. Among high-quality CBD options, Eat & Hemp's unfiltered full-spectrum CBD oil is an all-organic choice. Again, all organic choice. They're one of the first unfiltered CBD products to be USDA certified organic. This guarantees what you see is what you get. No toxins, no pesticides, no label trickery. Eat & Hemp uses hemp seed oil as a carrier for CBD, giving you the full entourage effect, maximum absorption, potency, effectiveness, terpenes, cannabinoids, aka results, which is all good things. And if you're like, supplementing, how do I even do this? Now, I personally take a dropper full a day with my dogs up until both our dogs passed away. Lexi was supplementing with 15 milligrams. She's a 60-pound dog. And Pebbles, who is a 10-pound dog, did a drop or two a day. Now with our dog Coconut, who's developed a little bit of inflammation, I've started giving her 10 milligrams a day, and she's an 80-pound dog. I personally couldn't even imagine my life without CBD. It extended Lexi's life by 3 years, giving us so much more time to spend together. together when vets said it wasn't even possible. I cannot tell you how powerful a supplement this has been for me and my family. Now, I chatted with my friends over at Eat and Hemp, and they put together a sweet deal for you. If you go to eatandhempcbd.com/keto diet, again, that's Eaton, E-A-T-O-N, hemp, cbd.com/keto diet, and use the coupon code keto diet. You're going to get 20% off all Eat and Hemp CBD products. That includes the salves and all the crazy things you can get into when it comes to CBD. That's 20% off with the code keto diet at eatandhempcbd.com/keto diet.
We've also seen plenty of bad players in the market who have either unknowingly brought very poor quality products to the market, just have a lack of expertise, or in even worse cases, have a lack of integrity. And that's led to a lot of people having a negative experience. And this is something that goes against our main goal. You know, we're here to try to connect as many people to this medicine as possible. And so while we're working so hard to do this right and to make it as widely available to people as possible and to give them the information they need to really navigate the space that in a way that's right for them. This is why we focus so heavily on education, by informing our customers. They're smarter customers, and that's how they have their power. We want folks to know how to try products, to find the right dosing for their needs. And this excites us because it hits our mission. We believe that there are very few brands out there that can live up to this at the same level of quality that we do. And that's why we share so openly and widely. Now, I'm very excited about a lot of our products that we have out there now. And I'm going to tell you a bit about each of those and also about a lot of the innovations we're working on, developing products that really dial into these unique terpene blends. I've spoken about the cannabinoids in CBD a little bit, but the other part of it is these terpenes, and they both work together to stimulate the endocannabinoid system. And by using certain blends of terpenes, we're able to dial in specific use cases, whether it's for pain or sleep or trauma, PTSD, anxiety, or even asthma. And so this is a very exciting space that we're starting to play in. And you could, you know, sign up for our email list, and we'll keep you up to date on this because it's really exciting. But we're really working on building a community here. We're hosting events and have a hemp hub that gears to bring it all together. The people who work in this business are all regular people, and we have a passion for holistic wellness. I'm a yogi, our whole team are all gym rats, and the bottom line is that we value health. We believe that health is wealth, and that's what we put into our products. So let's get into what makes our products so special, because I think there are some very definitive reasons. When CBD is extracted properly, it produces a medicine that works in harmony with our body and with nature, that activates the endocannabinoid system. Again, this helps us to stay in homeostasis, which keeps us healthy with a strong immune system. We work on our extraction method to make sure that it's the purest method and keeps the profile of our terpenes and cannabinoids intact. Now, I urge you to be careful when you're looking at CBD products and considering them in the market space. I want to make sure that you're equipped to ask the right questions, because there are some great brands and great products out there, but you really want to make sure that you know how to navigate that and look for the right ones. When considering one, you know, get to know them. Make sure that you know, you're getting the answers that you're looking for. Consider where the CBD was grown, by who, and how it was processed. Get to understand more about what those terms are. Again, you can go to our hemp hub, which we'll link here below. But if you go to eatandhempcbd.com/hemphub, you can find it there. Eat and Hemp is a farmer-owned company, and we have a strong set of values around creating the highest quality, most transparent products in the CBD space. With all the confusion in the space, we really wanted to make sure to provide a brand that people can trust. That's why we've partnered with leading functional medicine experts, doctors, and industry leaders to provide our customers with all the right information, and the right information for them specific, because we all have our own needs. We also have on every one of our products a special QR code. If you don't know what that is, it's a little weird black and white square, and if you take out your phone, take a picture of it, it pops up a website. clicks you right to it, and it has all of our lab reports on it. This means you get to see exactly what's in it, all of the cannabinoids, all the terpenes. It checks for a whole bunch of other things. And if you don't understand these or don't know how to read it, don't worry. We've invested a lot of time in developing our Hemp Hub, which brings together articles and videos that explain everything you need to know around hemp and CBD. And if you just don't really want to deal with all of that, we're here for you to ask the questions yourself. So shoot us an email or give us a call. Again, I'll have these linked with the podcast. So please, we're here to help. As I said, all of our products are USDA organic, and I want to talk about why that's important. I don't think USDA organic is the be-all, end-all in all cases, but here specifically, I think it provides a very important service. One key reason is because the hemp plant is used as a soil remediation crop. This means that it pulls toxins from the soil. After the nuclear devastation in Chernobyl and more recently in Fukushima, Japan, hemp was used to clean and repair the soil because it naturally pulls out those toxins. Now, while this is an incredible aspect of the plant and speaks to hemp's overall power, when making CBD from that plant, it's of the utmost importance that it's grown on clean, nutrient-rich, fertile soil, or you run the risk of it absorbing the toxins and pesticides that are found in the soil. And the best way we have currently found to ensure this is by certifying it USDA organic, because they guarantee there are absolutely no synthetic fertilizers or pesticides in the product. And if you think about it, you wouldn't go into a juice bar and order a non-organic juice, right? I mean, it's basically like getting a concentrated shot of pesticides and toxins in drink form. So this is exactly why organic's important here and why we're proud to be certified USDA organic.
I really hope you're enjoying today's episode. I'd love to see where you're listening from. You can snap a pic and tag me at Leanne Vogel or leave a review for the show on your favorite podcast player. It helps me out tremendously. Okay, back to the good stuff.
A couple more things about Eaton Hemp products is that they're also full spectrum and unfiltered. So what does this mean? Well, full spectrum means that it includes the full range of cannabinoids and terpenes found in the plant. Many brands pull out parts or isolate the CBD in a lab. There's a great quote from D-Hawk, "Nature will never surrender its secrets to the measure of the yardstick." And I think it applies greatly here. We know that there's much more happening in the whole plant and the wisdom of this plant that's evolved over millions of years, and trying to outsmart it is just silly. So we work hard to leave our products intact just the way that nature intended it and, you know, muddle with it as little as possible. Now, for some folks working in certain, say, governmental agencies or professional sports that have a zero tolerance rule on THC, they want a product that has it all removed, even the legal less than 0.3%. So for them, that makes sense. But for the average person, it has absolutely no bearing on them. It's like somebody not wanting to eat a poppy seed bagel out of a fear of having an issue with heroin. Right? So besides, you know, along with the cannabinoids, the terpenes are the other part of the plant that have many of the beneficial effects on our endocannabinoid system. They really help to stimulate a lot of points of it. We want those. That's why our products are unfiltered. We don't strain out the additional terpenes because they're so beneficial for things like inflammation, nerves, digestion, and cognitive function. So when you take our product, you'll taste the plant in it. If you're looking for a cherry cola flavored CBD product, we're not the company for you. You know, we treat this as a medicinal product. And so you're going to taste some of that. And you know, I actually love the taste of it. But, you know, that's also another reason that we keep it pure. We're not doing a product like a gummy because, you know, gummy, it's the antithesis, right? This is a product, CBD is incredible as an anti-inflammatory. You take a gummy that's high in sugar, and which is a known inflammation agent, I mean, you're countering exactly what the benefit is. So we're very cognizant of the products we do. We also don't do pills for the reason that while some prefer it, you absorb a lot less of the actual CBD through pill form because it's going in through your gut. And so it's a different function. you know, when we're using a tincture, you're getting a carrier oil, which for us, we are unique in that we use our own hemp seed oil, which is the carrier oil that carries the CBD into the bloodstream. Hemp seed oil is made from our hemp plants that we grow. We take the seeds and press them just like olive oil, and we use that extra virgin hemp seed oil for our tinctures. So you'll notice when you try ours out, it's pretty unique and special. And that adds to what the industry term is the entourage effect, that idea that the sum is far greater than the individual parts. And by using a carrier oil that comes from the same plant, you're maximizing that benefit. Now, when it comes specifically to you and CBD, it's important to understand that no two people have the same exact chemistry. And that's why taking it into your own hands is so important. Nobody is going to know you better than you know yourself. And if you feel disconnected from it, there are a lot of practices to start getting back in touch. And this is also why no two people will have the exact same plan for using CBD. So we always recommend starting with a small amount and increase it slowly. Just start to build that dialogue with your body and understanding how it's working and what works best for you. You know, nothing's going to go wrong by using too little or too much, but you want to find that place that really allows you to thrive. And again, we're always here to answer any questions you have. So please reach out. We love talking about this, if I haven't made that clear enough yet. At the end of the day, our mission is helping people to take control of their own health by tapping into the power of this plant. We're always here to incorporate CBD into your routine. And we have the Hemp Hub, again, to answer any questions you might have, as well as our staff that's on call to answer any questions you have. So I'll make sure Leanne has our contact to share with this podcast so that you have that direct line. Now, getting into our specific products, we offer a line of regular and extra strength tinctures. These are taken under the tongue sublingually or by adding it to your drink like a smoothie in the morning. And they're great for people and pets alike. We specifically did not create a separate pet line because we believe that our pets are our family. They deserve the exact same quality of product that we do. And so it's really just a matter of how much that they're taking. And again, go to our site and we have information about that. We have a specific page just for pets. So you can get the info there. But what I say to you is try it. See for yourself. And look, if you don't like it for any reason, maybe you prefer to have some aches. They remind you that life is not forever. No worries. We'll give you your money back, guaranteed. So this is a no-risk offer. We want as many people to try this as possible to see the special power of the hemp plant. So we're going to make it as easy as we can for you today. We also have a line of topical salves. You know, I love this. It comes in like a stick form, like you just rub it on. And I use it after a big workout if I'm sore, if I'm nursing an injury, which I inevitably have, especially the older I get, those aches and pains that just are there. I find it works great. And sometimes I'll, you know, double up. I'll use a topical and then take some internally. And the effects come on really fast. In the topical, we use our organic, unfiltered, full-spectrum CBD oil with some beeswax. We add some peppermint essential oil in to build some heat. And then we also use an infusion of MCT oil with arnica and black birch. These aren't some extracts we're buying. We're actually making this ourselves in the product. And these specifically, arnica and black birch, help with pain, with bruising, and inflammation. Start looking at some other medications out there. If you're not familiar with them, you'll start seeing them around. This is honestly one of my favorites. It's a must-have for everybody's cabinet, your travel bag, or your gym bag. And again, we're offering it with our no-risk money-back guarantee. You know, I'm a pretty wired person. I'm going nonstop all day. And for me, turning my mind off and sleeping solid, getting that REM sleep is tricky. The tincture has been an absolute lifesaver for me. Me personally, I use the extra strength. I built up to 2 dropperfuls and I get 8 hours of sleep solid, sometimes less when my son climbs into bed. But besides that, I get a deep rejuvenated sleep and I can't sing the praises enough. it's just incredible. And then what I do is I take a smaller dosage. I use the regular strength and take one dropper full in the morning to just, you know, ease anxiety. I live in New York and, you know, I'm in the city a lot, and that pace just, it has an effect on you. And so while I try to not drink too much caffeine, that also adds into it. And I find that, you know, CBD and caffeine as a combo, it allows you to get the focus from caffeine without activating the nervous system. So give it a try. And because you guys are friends with Leanne, we're going to offer a 20% discount on top of it. Again, we want to see as many people experience the magic of CBD as possible. So I'm doing everything I can to make it as easy as possible. And you know what? I'm going to even go a step further. If you spend over $200, I'm going to throw in a free small organic full spectrum super salve. Can I even do this? I don't know, but I just did. So please give it a try. Visit us at eatonhempcbd.com. Let us know any questions or comments and share your thoughts and experiences. And if for any reason you don't like it, let us know. We'll take it back and return your money. No questions asked. Thank you all for tuning in today, and please reach out with anything. Again, a huge thank you to Leanne. Love everything you're doing. This is Brian D'Alessandro, co-founder and CEO of Eaton Hemp, saying stay strong, stay healthy.
Great episode, right? I told you, Brian knows so much. So if you're like, OMG, I think CBD can work for me. Again, that link to get your 20% off if you decide to go with Eaton Hemp or not, it's totally cool. You get to decide. Go to eatonhempcbd.com/keto diet. Use a coupon code keto diet. And if you have any questions about CBD that you'd like me to answer, just head on over to healthfulpursuit.com/contact, and I'd love to help you out. Next up on the podcast on Sunday, May 24th, we have episode 249. Kim Kranz is coming on the show to talk about the path of neutrality. Oh, it's a good one. Tuesday, May 26th, we have episode 250. This is our first of what will hopefully be many more mid-week podcast episodes. I told you guys a couple of months ago that I was having a hard time finding podcast sponsors for mid-week episodes, so those went away on the podcast. Thankfully, Perfect Keto stepped up to the plate. My friends over at Perfect Keto not only make amazing products, but they're also so supportive of the people in our community that are trying to share quality content. So it was just so great that they stepped up and said, we want to support your show. Get that content back up. So episode 250, Sandra Steinbaum is going to be coming on the show to talk about behavior change for lasting health. That's a great episode too. So watch for that on Tuesday. Okay, I'll see you there. Bye. Thanks for listening to the Keto Diet Podcast. Join us again in a couple of days to discover more Keto for Women secrets for your fat-fueled life. The Keto Diet Podcast, including show notes and links, provides information in respect to healthy living, nutrition, and diet, and is intended for informational purposes only. The information provided is not a substitute for medical advice, diagnosis, or treatment, nor should it be construed as such. We cannot guarantee that the information provided on the Keto Diet Podcast reflects the most up-to-date medical research. Information is provided without any representations or warranties of any kind. Please consult a qualified physician for medical advice and always seek the advice of a qualified healthcare provider with any questions you may have regarding your health and nutrition program.